What's going on, friends? Welcome back to the channel. Just gonna jump straight into the makeup because I'm actually getting ready to go somewhere. I am going to go pick up something yummy and exciting today, so I wanted to take you guys along with me. I'm gonna do my face, show you an outfit, a real outfit that I'm gonna put on, not just like my jammies, you know. I'm putting on a real outfit and real shoes. We are actually sitting on my bed today, so if there is a little bit of movement, I am sorry. Okay, first things first with this face concealer. Gonna go in with the Glossier concealer. I actually see the bottom of this pot, so I'm more determined to use this now. Also, I just want kind of light-ish coverage because, you know, I'm only running one errand, and even though I want to look kind of cute, don't want to overdo it. I'm not gonna worry too much about the mouth area because we're gonna have to wear a mask anyway, so most of this part will be covered up. Gonna go in with a setting powder. I'm using the Innisfree No Sebum powder. This is the collaboration with Mentos in the melon flavor or fragrance. I really love this powder because the powder is so fine, and you can, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but oh, it is definitely flying up just the instant I touch it because it is so fine. Next, doing the brows, I'm gonna use the Tony Moly brow pencil. This pencil kind of has an angular tip. It has, I don't know if I can show you. Can I do this? Can you see it if it's like that? I don't know if you can see it, but it's kind of like a teardrop triangular shape. I really like the shape of this brow pencil. Also, it's not too creamy, but it's not too dry. It's just right in between, perfect consistency. Also, the spoolie on the other end is super big and fluffy. It really grabs onto your brow hairs when you brush it through. I don't know if you guys can hear the yard work being done outside. I feel like there's always someone mowing their lawn or cutting the hedges or something. I'm just glad they're not doing it at like 8 o'clock in the morning anymore. Just some light brows because we are gonna go for a pretty light look, eye look. Now jumping into the eyeshadow, it's gonna be using this ColourPop collection, Princess collection, what is this called? Designer, Disney Designer collection. I got this palette from my friend Tina. Look how beautiful these colors are. When I first got this palette from her, I was using it so much. I kept repeating this one look. I probably did it for like a whole month because I was just in love with that look so much. But the matte colors up here are super beautiful, and these shimmers are very unexpected. They look very beautiful and a little different from what you expect from the pot, but colors are great. Today, just gonna do a simple look. I'm probably gonna take Grumpy, which is this matte brown here in the center. I feel like it's like the perfect matte brownish with a little bit of a hint of pink for my skin tone. I love this color so much. Just all over the lid for a wash of color. See how beautiful? It's just nice and neutral. I'm pretty lazy about changing my brushes out, so I am going to stick with the same fluffy brush. I'm going to go into the color right next to it, which is called Triton. It is a deeper, more yellow-brown color, and I'm going to put that on the outer half of the eyes. Final step, still using this brush, is taking the color Enchanted Rose. It is this shimmer color down here. I'm gonna put that just in the center of the lids. Next, I'm gonna take Beast, which is a dark brown color down here. It has a little bit of shimmer in it, but you can't really see it too much. I'm gonna take a flat shader brush and use that dark Beast color as a liner. I've started keeping my liner fairly straight. I stopped kind of flicking it upward. I'm gonna let the eyes sit for a little bit and move on to the rest of the face. This is still one of my favorite blushes. This is the ColourPop Coast to Coast. I got this with the Mauve collection. Ooh, I forgot my blush brush. Hold on one second. Oh, now we are back. The white balance is going crazy because I'm sitting right next to the window. Anyways, I love this blush color and I kind of go heavy-handed with my blushes, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm actually gonna skip over bronzing because, like I said, our face is mostly gonna be covered with a mask anyway. So I do want a little bit of blush because you'll see a little bit of color there. And I'm gonna do a very subtle highlight. This is Fenty's Kilowatt. I'm gonna take, which one is this? Mean Money, which is this lighter one here. This one is Hustler Baby. It's super shimmery, but this one is a little more subtle. I'm gonna speed you guys through the lashes real quick using this Shiseido lash curler, and this is the L'Oreal mascara. I already have my eyes on the next drugstore mascara that I want to buy. I think it's from Maybelline. It's in a pink, like a light pink bottle. We're gonna finish off with the lips, and since we use the Disney collection today, I also received the lipstick. Thanks, Tina. This one is Belle's lipstick. Look how beautiful this is. It is kind of dark, so I'm going to just smudge it into the... I'm gonna place it in the center. I'm gonna just smudge it out. I don't think I'm ever gonna go back to wearing like a full lip. It just feels too heavy, especially a liquid lip. I still smudge out my liquid lips. I smudge out all my lipstick, but especially liquid lip, I don't think I'll ever wear a full lip. I could probably still do a full lip of like the creme lipsticks, but I love this what kind of faded look the most. Okay, that is it for the makeup. Very natural, very appropriate to go pick up some... Did I mention what I was gonna pick up? Donuts? I'm gonna tell you guys now, I pick up donuts. Okay, let's get to the outfit. What's going on, friends? Got my outfit on. This top is from Brandy Melville. This is one of the first tops that I've ever bought from Brandy Melville in 2013. It's just a flowy crop top, kind of like a fake suede material or something. It's held up well through all this time. I mean, 7 years is a long time for just like a shirt. I also have these pants from Urban Outfitters. These are the Kick Flare pants. There's kind of a little bit of a flare to it. I'll link these below. I got these a while back, so I don't know if they'll still be on the website, but I did notice a lot of other Kick Flare style pants being sold on there right now. I'm gonna top everything off with my Doc Marten boots. I am not gonna put these on inside the house, so you'll just have to see it in a picture. Or I'll see it later when I bring you guys out. But these are the cherry red. I wore Docs almost all winter because I bought them right before Christmas. But my boyfriend got these for me for Valentine's Day in the red. I bought the black ones back in December. But I didn't get a chance to wear these very much because right after Valentine's Day was this whole situation. So I'm busting these out today, even though it's like 75 degrees. I'm gonna wear those boots. I'm gonna wear those dang boots. Those boots and these pants are giving me a little bit of a retro 90s like grunge vibe. So that's what I'm going for today. Okay, let's go out. I only got 6 today because I tried to get 12 last time. It was kind of a lot. But today's flavors are pandan, mango, and I'm most excited for this, which is milk tea sugar. Oh my god, it's so hot. I'm like shiny. Anyways, I just got back home. I had a little bit of each of the flavors. So out of the 3 flavors today, I really like the mango one the most. I feel like I was expecting a lot out of the milk tea sugar one just because I love milk tea. But I don't really taste any like milk tea flavor in the sugar topping. I mean, it's still good, but like I feel like I just expected a little bit more of a fragrance. It's okay, it's still good. If you guys don't know what mochi donuts are, they're donuts made of mochi. I think it's made of tapioca, with tapioca flour or something. So there's a little bit of a chew to it. It's so yummy, it's so addicting. It doesn't taste like a regular donut where it's kind of like a soft spongy cake, but it has a little bit of a chewy QQ texture, which is so addicting. So if you get a chance to order it from the
Mitsuya in San Jose, do it. And I love their new system where you order online and then you pick like a time slot. You don't gotta wait anymore, just pay online and go pick it up. The only thing now is that you can't really customize it, and the flavors are already predetermined the week before. Flavors come out Saturday, so go online Saturday, pick your slots. The slots go pretty fast. So yeah, enjoy. I'm gonna go eat some more. Just wanted to say goodbye to you, and thanks for watching. Bye.